Welcome to the USB PD Charge EVM01 Bring Up Video Tutorial. My name is Mike Emanuel and I am an Applications Engineer. Today we will give a basic PD tutorial, show how to power on the USB PD Charge EVM01, show how to establish a basic PD contract for 15 volts, and show how to read the PD logs. USB power delivery functions using USB Type-C cables. To work, a source and a sink are needed. The top half of the Power Duo board can act as a PD source. The bottom half of the Power Duo board can act as a PD sink. USB PD allows applications to negotiate contracts above 15 watts using a standard Type-C cable. For this demo, we will be using the following: a USB PD Charge EVM01, the Power Duo source board, a 4-quadrant power supply, and power and connection cables. Specifically, a USB PD cable is needed. For the rest of the video, I will be calling the USB PD Charge EVM01 as the EVM, and the Power Duo source board as the source board, and the 4-quadrant power supply as the battery. First, I will start with two examples of how to use the EVM. The first picture on the left shows how the EVM can be used as a source. The second picture on the right shows how the EVM can be used as a sink. Please attach the battery to the battery connector on J2 to power the EVM. The battery is necessary to use the EVM as a source and a sink. The EVM comes with an out-of-the-box default flash image that can perform power delivery. When the EVM is connected to a PD source, it can act as a PD sink to charge the battery and/or deliver power to the system load. Please connect the barrel jack to the source board and connect the source board to the EVM using a USB PD cable. We will use the source board to demonstrate the power contract negotiation with the EVM by syncing power to the EVM. First, please attach a 10-volt battery, making sure jumpers JP2 and JP4 are populated as by default. The default flash image has 15-volt sync capabilities enabled. When the source board is connected and the 15-volt contract button is pushed, the 15-volt LED lights up on the source board and the PPHV test point will measure 15 volts. Notice how the voltage changes from the default 5 volts from the source board to the desired 15 volts when pushed. Also, notice the charge current going into the battery is 1 amp. This is from the default charge parameters loaded on the device. Please note the charge current flow from the barrel jack into the source board through the USB PD cable into the EVM and to the battery. In order to better understand the communication of the PD contracts, we can use a tool called a PD analyzer. The PD analyzer allows us to decode the PD communication. If we look at the PD logs, we can also see the power negotiation taking place. The source, which is the source board, sends its source capabilities by sending individual power data objects, or PDOs. When the 15-volt button is pushed, we see 3 PDOs sent from the source board. These capture the power options the source offers. Please note that the PD analyzer is not included with the EVM. Here's a highlight of the source capabilities being sent. Notice that 15 volts is the third object being sent. Next, the EVM requests position 3, or the third PDO, which is for 15 volts. Last, the contract is accepted and the power supply is enabled. Next, we see on the oscilloscope that the PD voltage transitions from 5 volts to 15 volts at 2.7 seconds when all of the PD logs indicate the negotiations are taking place.